Getting your data from a web page into Excel isn't always easy. Well, the good news is that Excel's web connector recently got an upgrade, which makes it a lot easier for us to import data from the web. Okay, so here's the thing. Easier is an understatement. As ChatGPT would say, it's a game changer. So check this out. I have this web page with some header text. Then I have some blocks down here. So we have some popular course package blocks. And then we have separate blocks for individual courses. Now, there are no HTML tables on this page. What if I needed to bring the information about each course as a separate row in Excel? So I wanted to have a separate column for the course category, another one for course name, for lessons, and so on. Notice these blocks are clickable, so it's going to be a nightmare to grab this text. I'd have to find a way to like copy this, bring it to Excel, format it the way I want. And then if I wanted to bring over the links, it's going to add to that nightmare, right? If I hover over this, we can see the link on the bottom. And then on top of that, the whole process is manual, right? If I add new blocks, I'd have to repeat this nightmare over again. Well, the new Power Query connector puts an end to all this. Check out the end result. This is what we can achieve. We get all the information that we need from each block directly into an Excel table that's connected to the web page. We have clickable links, plus we get to have our images here. And all of this is dynamic. So if the web page content updates, all I have to do is refresh my query and I get the new clickable links added together with the images. This is super cool. And as you can see, I'm super excited about this. So originally, I had another web page in mind where I wanted to demonstrate this Power Query connector, but that one didn't have links and images. Then I saw a request come in that asked us for a list of our courses, the number of lessons, and the course link. And that got me thinking, I should be able to use the Power Query connector, and there must be a way to bring over the links and the images, right? When there's a will, there is a way. So let me show you my process from scratch. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is grab the URL of the page that you want to import. So I'm going to Control C this to copy it, go open a new blank Excel workbook, go to Data, From Web, and paste in the URL that you just copied and click on OK. Now Power Query is going to create a connection to that web page and it's going to try to identify any official tables and also any patterns that it finds, and it's going to present those to you as suggested tables. So for example, under suggested table 1, I can see this table was picked up. Now if we take a closer look at this, these are actually our course blocks. We have the course category here, then we have the name, we have a short description, the number of lessons, and then the Join Now button. So it starts with Power BI and it ends with Google Sheets. Now, if you want to compare this to the actual content of the web page, you don't have to open up your browser. You can just switch to Web View in the same window. You get to see the content of the page. The images just don't load, but that doesn't matter. We can see what table 1 contains. It actually starts from this section right here, so under Courses Designed to Help You Succeed, and then it ends right here with Google Sheets, so just before the ebook section. Now you can take a look at the other suggested tables. I'm going to switch to table view again to see if it has the contents that you need. This one is information on cookies. We don't need that. This one contains some more information. This contains pretty much all the blocks that we have. We also see the popular course packages here and also the ebooks. Now, one thing that all of these suggested tables don't have is the course link. They also don't have the course image. So what are our other options? Well, we have the HTML code here. You might find this useful depending on the type of analysis that you are doing. I don't need it in this analysis. We also have the displayed text. To grab exactly what I want, I need to go to Add Table Using Examples. This allows me to give Power Query a list of what I want, and it's going to try and pick up a pattern. Let's say from this page, I want the course category, the course name, the number of lessons, the link to the course, and the image that comes with this course. So I'm going to start with the course name. I'll call this column name. The name of the course is this one. So you can start typing in. So I'm going to go with fast track, and you're going to see it pop up in this list, which makes it super easy. So we're just going to double click to select it. Next, I want the course category, and this is going to be Power BI. That's this one right here. Next, let's also add in the number of lessons. And here it's 125 lessons. Now we want to grab the link. For the course link, it's going to start with HTTPS. We get a list of all the links here, and we have to know what that link is. So this one right here is linked to this course. So that's Fast Track to Power BI. That's what we need. Last, I want to grab the image, and the image is also a link. So I'm going to start with HTTPS. Let's just scroll down to get to the images. We can see these .png, .jpg files. The one for Power BI is right here. So let's select that. So we gave it one example. It hasn't picked up a pattern. We need to give it another example. So I'm going to come here and start typing in the next course, which is Master Excel Power Query Beginner to Pro. It's this one right here. I'm going to press enter, and I can see a pattern was picked up. Next, which category is this? This is in the Excel category. When I select it and press enter, a pattern is picked up. The number of lessons here is 185, and again, a pattern was picked up. Now let's do that for the link as well. Select the link, press enter, and let's move to the images. This time I'm just going to start typing in PNG to get all the images. That's the one for Power Query. So now that it's picked up a pattern, this is going to be dynamic. So if I add a new block to this section, it should be automatically picked up. I click on OK, and I get a new custom table created. I'm going to go ahead and transform the data. Let's adjust the query name to courses. Now we can see that a couple of steps were automatically added. So that's the source step. That's the URL. Then this part is extracted table from HTML. So if I click on this gear icon, I go back to adding table using examples. Then I got a change type step automatically applied. Now, at this point, you can add any type of transformation step that you want. For example, we could remove lessons from this step, right? I can just select this, go to replace values, find space lessons, and replace it with nothing. Click on OK. And then let's just apply a change type step. I'm actually going to push this change type step down. I'm just going to drag and drop it down here, and I'll just go and update it to a whole number for this one. And let's replace current. So these are links, right? But there is no data type that's called link or URL. So what's going to happen when I send this to Excel? Let's go ahead and close and load. Let's just load this to a new page. Well, I get my course information in a nice table, but I don't have my images, and the links that I get aren't clickable. To get these to be clickable, I'd have to go into edit mode, so I'll have to double click in the cell, press enter, and then I get clickable links, or I have to use other workarounds. But I don't want that. I want these links to be clickable from the start. So if I get new course blocks on that web page and I refresh my query, these links are going to be immediately clickable. Plus, I'm going to see the images of the courses and not this link. All I have to do is make one tweak to Power Query. So we're going to go and edit the query, go to transform, structured column, and select create data type. This feature is an underused feature in Power Query, and it's super helpful for these situations and any situation where your data has some characteristics. So like if you're dealing with master data, in this case, our data type name is our courses, right? That's what describes the data, course or courses. Then we decide on what are the characteristics of this data type. So we want to have the category as part of the course. the number of lessons. So I'm just going to multi-select these and add these together to this side. Okay, now you're going to see how cool this feature is. I'm going to click on OK, and I get my course data type here. So every time I click to the side, on the bottom, we get the additional characteristics. I see the name, category, lessons, and so on, and I have the ability to expand this, but I don't want that. All I want is the data type, and I'm going to send this back to Excel. Okay, let me just go ahead and change the table design. I'm not going to take it away completely. I'll just go with this more minimalistic look, and let's go ahead and remove the grid lines as well. Here comes the fun bit. What we're going to do is either click on these cards. So these cards show you the additional characteristics of each of these courses. We see the name, category, lessons, link, and image. So you can click on these and add a new column. So let's say we want the category as well. So I'm going to click on that plus, and it's going to add a new column here. Let's click on the plus here, add the number of lessons as well. I want to have the link, and I want to have the images. It kind of looks like we are back to the same problem that we had, right? None of these are clickable and I don't have my images. But wait a second, there is something different this time. Look at the formula bar. It's using a formula, right? It's referencing the data type here, which is the course, and then .link grabs the link information. .image grabs the image information. Now, because I'm dealing with formulas here, and these are table formulas, I can update this formula. I'm going to use the hyperlink function to change this text into a hyperlink. So I'm going to press enter, and the whole column updates immediately. What am I going to do with this? Well, I'm going to use the new image function to grab all the images. All of these links are clickable. So if I click on this, I go to the Essentials page. Now I just want to expand these columns so that I can see the images better. And just to make sure that nothing shifts again or nothing auto fits again when I refresh this, I'm going to go to Data, Properties, and let's uncheck Adjust Column Width. Okay, so that's it. We have everything we need. All we need to do is test if it really works. So I've gone ahead and updated our course page by including a new block for our newest course called Quick Wins with ChatGPT. The question is, when I update my Power Query table, am I going to see this image and am I going to see a clickable link? Let's test it out. Let's go back to our Excel table. This is it. The last one is Google Sheets. Let's right mouse click and refresh. And we get Quick Wins with ChatGPT. We have a clickable course link right here, and we can see the course image. This is super cool, and you can pretty much use this technique on any web page that you come across, as long as it doesn't have JavaScript that changes the load behavior of the page on the fly. Before we wrap up, if you've enjoyed this sneak peek into the power of Power Query, you're gonna love what's in store for you in our Master Power Query Beginner to Pro course. Over 50,000 professionals have transformed their Excel skills with our Power Query course. So whether you're just starting out or looking to sharpen your Excel skills, this course is gonna be your ticket to becoming an Excel pro. Check out the link in the description to start learning today. Thank you for watching till the end. Thank you for being here, and don't forget to like this video if you found some value in it, and do subscribe if you aren't subscribed yet, and I'll catch you in the next video.